Hello everyone, welcome back once again to my video tutorial. This is Lipsa again with you. So we have been discussing about the stream operation. So what is this stream operation? So you know stream is used to process the data or process the object from collection, right? So to process this data, we need certain operations or methods that is known as stream operation. So we have two types of stream operations. One is intermediate operations and other is terminal operations. So what is this intermediate operations? So these operations or methods is used to transform one stream to another stream. Okay, so return type of this intermediate operation is always a stream. Correct. So what are the intermediate operations we have in stream? We have the filter, map, flatmap, sorted, distinct, limit, and skip. So in my last video, I have shown you some of the examples on filter. So today we will learn about this map. So if you recall correctly, what filter does exactly? So filter applies some condition and based on that condition, it filter out the data. Okay, so we'll see today what map does. So let's get started for this. Let me go to my IntelliJ workspace and this is the project we have created earlier, Java and Stream API project. Inside this project, I have the package like intermediate operation demo. So inside this intermediate operations demo, we have created the sub package like filter examples. So today I'll create another sub package for map. Okay. So let me create the sub package quickly. New package. So I'll create map examples. Map examples. Okay. So my sub package is ready. Now I'll show you the first example in map. So for this, let me create a class, let's say demo1. Okay, so inside this class, I'll create a main method to test our code. Clear? So before writing any code on map, so let's check what map does actually. Okay. So map is used to convert data from stream of X to stream of Y. Suppose we have a stream of X. We want to convert it to another form, let's say stream of Y. Okay. So what map does? Map takes each element of stream X and performs certain operations on it and store the result in other collection. Okay. So let's check it practically. Okay. So let's say I have a list of integer. Let's say I have a list of integer. Okay. So let's say list. I am creating a list array as list. Inside this list, I am providing 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. This one. Okay. So my list is ready. So now I want to create a result list which contains the square of this number. 2, 3, 5, 7, 9. Okay. So how we can do this? So let's say without using stream, how we can do this? Let's check. Then I'll show you how we can do this using stream. So let me write this without using stream. So without using stream. Okay. Let me give the comment like this without using stream. Let me create a result list for it to add the result. Result list. Okay. View array list. This is also going to return me an integer type array. So this is my result list. Now I iterate this list. Here I iterate this list. Let me create a for each. So for each element of list, integer n. For each element of this list, what I'll do? I'll just simply square up this number. So that means number into number. Okay. So and I will do number into number, then I'll add the result to result list. So I can do like this result list dot add. Then inside this, I'll add what? Number into number. Square up the number. Okay. Then I just simply in this result list. Correct. So let me quickly run this one. Okay, you can see the result. Square of 2 is 4, square of 3 is 9, square of 5 is 25, square of 7 is 49, and square of 9 is 81. So our result list contains the square of each element of this list. Clear? So this is without using stream. So now we will see how we can do this using stream. Okay. So let me give the comment like this. Using stream. So first we need to convert this list to stream by using list.stream method. So list.stream. Okay. We convert this list to stream. Then we will use map. So map accept a function. See here. Map accept a function. So it takes each element of this list, each element of this list, and perform certain operations, and will collect the result in our target or in other collection. Okay. So it takes one element, let's say n, then lambda accession start. So please remember to use this intermediate operations or terminal operations or any kind of stream operations. You should are aware of this lambda expression concept. Okay. Please go through my playlist on it, lambda expression. So you can understand this statement. So n lambda expression start, then we'll provide the word body n into n. So that will take each element of n and perform this operation, multiply n with n. Then what happens? Then we'll collect our result to our target list by using collectors.toList. Clear? So this is also written as a what? So let me just comment this out and store this result in our result list and print this result list. So this is also going to return us the same result as before. The first one is without using stream, the second one is using stream. Clear? Run the application again. Okay, we are getting the same result in our output. So I can also do like this. I can also print the value. Instead of storing this value to another list, I can simply use the for each terminal operation to print the value. Okay. Dot out lambda expression start println. So this is the method reference. Okay, I can do like this. Let me just comment this line so that it can see the output. Let me run the application. Clear. So the value is printed in the console. Here, this one, the map concept. So map will accept a function. It will take each element of this list and to perform certain operation on it. And we can collect the result to another list, or we can just simply show the result in the console, or we can use it for further purposes. Okay, so this is the first example on map. So let me show you another example. Let me create another class for it. Let's say demo2, and I will create a main method as well. Main method created. Now let me create a list of string here. Okay, so this is my list. Now, I want to convert each element of this list to uppercase. Okay, how we can do this? So, let me show you without using stream. Okay, how we can do this? We just simply iterate this list. That's the string name list. Then, we'll create a result list for this, of course. Let me change the name to result list. Result list is equal to new array list. Okay. It iterates each element of this list. Then we convert each name to uppercase. So for this we have the method like name. What? Name dot to uppercase. This is the method. So we need to add this in our result list. So just simply copy this one, result list dot add. just put this value inside it. Now if I'll print it in my console, I'll get all the elements in the list is in uppercase. Let me run this application. Okay, see, all the elements is coming in uppercase. So this is without using string. Now if we write this program using string, how we can do this? Simply let me comment this out. So first we need to convert this list to what? String. Convert this list to string. Then we use which function to convert stream of x to stream of y? We need map function. So map will accept a function. So it will take each element of this list. So let's say name, then lambda expression start, then name dot to uppercase. Okay. So I don't want to store it in any other collection. I just want to print the value in the console. So for each, I'll use system dot out double colon operator println. Okay. It will keep all the name in what? Uppercase. If I run this one, then I can see all the name in uppercase. See, I'm getting all the name in uppercase in my console. So if you want, you can store this one to another collection, or you can simply store the result in the console as well. Clear? If you want to add, then you can just simply do like this. Dot collect collectors to list. Okay. And assign it to result list. Clear? If you want to see the result, then you can print the result list as well here. Clear? See. So you can see all the result printed in the console, as well you can see the result list. Contents or all the names is converted to or transferred to uppercase. Clear? So now we'll see another example on this map. So now I'll combine this filter and map together and create an example. Okay. So let me create another class for this, demo3. Inside this demo3, I'll create a main method. I create a main method. Okay. Now, so if you recall, we have created a class in our util package, that is employee, which contains the field like ID, name, email and salary. So now I'll create an employee list, and I want to create my result list which contains the name of the employee which has the salary greater than certain value. Clear? So I want to create a result list which contains only the name of the employee which has the salary greater than 25,000. Okay, so let me create the employee list first here. So this is my employee list. Okay, so this is my employee list. So what I need to do? I need to create a result list which contains the name of the employee which has the salary greater than 25,000. Okay, so first I need to filter out the employee which has the salary greater than 25,000. For this I need to use the filter method. Okay, so let me first add this employee list to stream. So how I can do this? By using list.stream. Okay, now I want to filter. I want to filter all the employee which has the salary greater than 25,000. The filter will take a predicate. So it will, let's say emp, then lambda expression stat, then I'll write the condition for it, employee dot get salary. So what is the condition? Greater than 25,000. So it will filter out all the employee list which has the salary greater than 25,000. So I'll get a list like this one, 30,000, 40,000, 28,000 and 50,000. So this employee will be filtered out from this employee list. Now I want to create the result list which contains only the employee name. So now I'll use the which concept? I'll use map. Okay. I will use map. Map will take a function. So employee employee date, date name. From this employee list, from this filter out employee list, I want to only take the what? I want to take the only employee name. So employee name, then I'll collect this by using dot collect collectors dot to list. Clear? Or my target list will be a what? String. Because I want to collect all the employee name only. So which is a string type. So my result list should be a string type, not employee type. It should be a string type. So string employee, let's say I'm giving like name list. Okay. So this is my target, or this is target collection, or this is my result. Okay. So now I'll print this name list. Okay, hope you understood this one. Let me just write this better to understand. Okay, so first we convert this list to stream by using employee list dot stream. Then we filter out all the employee from this given list which has a salary greater than 25,000 by using this filter method. Then we want to just collect all the employee name which has a salary greater than 25,000. That's why we use this map and get name from this list and collect this list and store it in our target collection. Okay. And print that value. So we should get this one, Daisy, Michael, Sanya and Robin in our output. So let's check. See, we are getting the same result in our console. So hope you understand this map concept, why we use map, and for example on filter with map as well. So that's it for today's video. Hope you like this video. See you in my next video. Till then, thanks for watching. Thank you.